Welcome back. This is Yama Jack. Today we have Gunslinger, Suicidal KF Rick, and I have to show you this right now. This thing here. I have to show it to you. I just have to make sure everything is all good on the screen here. I have to show you this. I had a chess match, and I'm so happy with it. Everything seems to be good. Yes. So we'll switch over. So the chess game I had was against Slurpy Money. We're at like the 400s ish, you know, the rating. We're not very good. But this one, I had 93.3% accuracy, and I've had better. I've had a 99.1% accurate game before, but that one I felt like it was pretty. Kind of felt pretty lucky, in my opinion. Like I felt like I got lucky. Like they made a whole bunch of just terrible mistakes, and I was like, well, I have to respond like this. Like you're just opening it up. Like what else am I gonna do? So like I felt like I got lucky, and I got to kind of demolish. In this one, I felt like I had just this like total control the whole game. So here's the list of moves if you want it. We started off with the Portuguese opening and moved into whatever this is. We'll go through the game here right quick. So we start off with the Portuguese opening, which is what I tend to do because I'm Portuguese and I gotta represent, right? We moved into the Rui Lopez opening, Tarash, whatever variation. And then stuff started to kind of fall apart for them as they made a couple of mistakes, and I got to kind of respond. This is the moment where, in my opinion, I was like, wow. So you move down here. This opens up this amazing pin here. Like, I'm like, I don't know what the heck you're doing, but I get everything. Get the rook. I get the queen. I get the king. Like, it's just, see ya. So I take their king. They take my knight, and I'm like, whatever, dude. I'll put you in check again. And we'll go over to the analysis. These are all like best moves, dude. It's all great. I don't like trading the bishop for the knight here so much, personally. I know it's good, I just don't really like it. I don't mind trading the knight for the knight there. Now this would have been also a good move, because it would have given us some stuff there. I kind of liked this move more, because it let this be open along this path for later on as well, though. Maybe that's wrong. I'm a 445 rating player here, okay? Because it did open up this, but I still would have just taken with the bishop. I wasn't really too worried about that. He took with this, and I was like, dude. Like, and then he resigned after that. But this one, this was the first match that I've had where I felt like I was kind of controlling everything the whole time, and it felt like just... Like, I saw the series of things that were happening, like, just so far in advance, and, like, I was, like, planning everything out, and I was like, yeah, so you're gonna do this, maybe, you're gonna do this, maybe, and like, this will happen, and, like, these things were happening, and it was just working, and, ah, it felt so good. I am getting better at chess. I've been playing a few games every day, and I've been doing the puzzles every day as well. I'm getting to consistently higher ratings in the puzzles. So in the puzzles, I get to typically about 700 to 800 for the puzzles. I do the puzzle rush survival thing. Three of those every day. And I typically get to about the 700, 800-ish before I start to kind of fall apart. And then I've been playing some games as well. I've had a few mates in like just really, really low move counts. I've been mated in really, really low move counts before too, but I've had a few mates in really, really low move counts. I think my best was mate in 6 or something, which I just did earlier today. I typically start off with the Portuguese opening or Sicilian defense. I don't know my openings, like I haven't studied it. I've just been like kind of just playing. Doing things that I think look like they'd be good moves, and then going over the analysis and being like, okay, so that wasn't a good move, what would you have rather me done, and kind of like learned that way. And I've been making some noticeable improvements, so I've been learning tactics and strategies that I should be using and stuff, and it feels really, really good. when I kind of know what I'm doing and I'm able to see all of these things that are happening on the board and find somebody who just makes a couple mistakes and I just get to capitalize on it and just like slam it down and really just kind of pull things together from there, and it just, it feels really, really good. So in that game, if they didn't resign, what would I have done? I probably would have started just kind of like dismantling their ranks, honestly, and then mated with probably a rook and a queen, is my guess. I can't remember the exact board state. I know you're just looking at it, but probably would have taken a bishop. Maybe got a pin on the a knight and a or on the a pin on the king and the rook to take out their other rook. Something like that kind of stuff to be able to take it to mates. But they resigned. I mean, when you lose your queen like that, you really should just resign, honestly. It's not even about, like, you can pull it back. It's more that, like, in order for you to pull it back, I have to make a mistake. Like, I have to mess something up. You've already messed up. You messed up first, so just accept your loss, you know? Like, people don't really do that. I don't do that sometimes, and I've won. But, and I don't get mad. I mean, I'm sure at like higher, you know, ranks or whatever. When you take somebody's queen like that, and you probably wouldn't in the first place, just because it wouldn't happen. But when you do, I imagine that people generally just resign. I've been watching Gotham Chess a little bit, and he was facing off against Beth Harmon's computers. And in it, he was remarking that he doesn't actually know how to, like, mate very well, because at that level of chess, people aren't really mating. You just, like, get to the point where your opponent is like, okay, yeah, you're gonna end up mating me eventually, so I'll just resign. So you don't, he was like, I don't actually, like, know. He doesn't actually, like, know how to get to a mate very easily. I mean, he's able to do it, but, like, that's the thing, right? Is anybody at that level is gonna be able to do it. It's just a matter of, like, you know, what way is the best way, and, you know, how are you actually going to get it to mate? You know, like, what's the best strategy here, and what's the safest strategy? So you don't do it because people just resign. So I assume that at those higher ratings, anybody who loses their queen in that kind of situation is going to just resign, because you messed up, you lost your queen. You don't stand a chance, you know? If you're both of equal, or even if you're, like, better, you don't stand a chance, you know? I suggest you purchase armor. Now, there are some situations where you want to sacrifice your queen because it gets you mate. Like, I've done that, right? Like, they have a rook on your queen or something like that, but you have a rook on, like, a piece that's more important than your queen is right now, because you get to, like, take the piece, it puts them in check, and then they're able to move or something, and then they take your queen, but then you're able to, like, pull something up and end up checkmating them, and they've just focused on your queen, and it's like, well, whatever, dude, take my queen, I don't care, don't need it, you know? Sometimes it's best to sacrifice it, but that's not one of those situations, you know? That's definitely not one of those situations. You never want to put your queen and your king in a forkable situation like that. I mean, you never really want to put your anything and your anything in a forkable situation, but especially your king and a high value piece like a rook or a queen. You never want to do that. That's a bad move. That is a very bad move. Cause then you have to move your king. You know? Or protect it, but especially with a knight. You know, if there's nothing that's able to take the knight. The knight's able to jump over ranks and stuff, so you can't really, like, move something in the way. But it was just a really, really satisfying game to play the whole way through. I really felt like I was in control. I really felt like I knew what I was doing, and the analysis kind of backs me up on that. And yeah, it was some of the most fun I've had playing chess. I've been having a lot of fun playing it, though. And like I said, I am getting better. It's nice to be getting better, because, you know, when I first, like, even like you saw, like, my rating was like 445 or something. A week ago, I was struggling to get past like 350, you know? And 350 to 450, that's not like a huge improvement. And I'm consistently staying there. Like that's what my rating is. That's fairly, you know, standard. That's what I am. You know, I'm equal to about like a 4-year-old playing chess, right? just seeing this improvement and being able to kind of have a little bit more fun with it is actually like just really good fun. I'm not gonna get into learning all the openings and all that. Like I don't want to study. You know what I mean? I don't want to study. I don't want to study the openings, and I don't want to study the mates, and I don't want to study this. I have been doing a few mates, just to have a little bit of fun with it, like with some puzzly kind of stuff. But you know, I don't want to study. I don't want to like watch a video on chess strategy. You know, I want to play the game, and I'll get better over time. And if I get to, you know, maybe 1,000, 1,200 rating at the absolute max, then you know, that's pretty good. I'm pretty good at picking things up as I kind of go, you know? Kind of paying attention to what moves I'm playing and what opening that is and how good it is and what kind of, like, benefit it gives me. You know, like, kind of like using the analysis to teach me, kind of like machine learning, you know? Like, you feed the machine a whole bunch of data points and you say, hey, this one was good, this one wasn't. It's basically what I'm doing. I'm the machine and the machine is me. So I'm, you know, feeding myself a bunch of data points, and then the machine's being like, this one's good, this one's bad, you know? And then I'm like, okay, I won't do that one again. And then, over time, I just kind of slowly improve, and I get better and better. Sometimes I just want to go for a cheeky mate, especially at this kind of rating. When I end up losing a few times or something, sometimes I'll go for a cheeky mate, you know? You put your queen in, like, just the dumbest position, that you could lose it, and at this rating they just don't see it, so they end up not taking your queen, and then you get to mate. It's always good fun when you mate in, like, you know, 5, 6, 7, 8, you know, kind of turns there, moves. It's good fun. It's good fun. It's not good practice. It's not good. I'm not learning anything doing that, but it is good fun to just pick it apart like that. So it won't work at like probably like even like 700. It will just never work to do that. But you know, when you're facing off against somebody like, you know, 300 or 400 or something, it's it can feel pretty good. But it's been good fun. Anyway, I want to talk about Amazon and their Alexa stuff. I want to talk about some of this stuff. Okay, so. They're apparently making a, like, wireless public Wi-Fi mesh network thing with all of the Amazon Alexa devices. So, if you have an Alexa device, if you have a Ring doorbell or something, then, you know, it'll connect to your neighbor's Ring doorbell and share your Wi-Fi with. So as people are walking around on the sidewalk or whatever, they just have this public Wi-Fi network kind of stretching out all over the place. And it's using, you know, your network and your neighbor's networks to make that happen. This is a stupid thing to do. Terribly, terribly, terribly stupid. And the best part about it is that it's opt-out, which is just, like, stupid, right? Like, why is that even allowed? Like, why is that even legal? Anyway, a bit of a PSA, I guess. If you guys own any Amazon Alexa devices, and you get an email, if you're in America, it'll probably come to other countries eventually, but it's only starting in America. But if you're in America and you own any Amazon Alexa devices, and you get this email talking about, like, Sidewalk and neighbors and wireless mesh and the benefits of, you know, sharing your Wi-Fi to your neighbors and yada yada yada, you know, all this kind of stuff. If you get that kind of email explaining it to you, just make sure you opt out. You know, they're saying, you know, we gotta work out all the things to make sure it's nice and secure and people aren't getting, you know, there isn't any abuse. There will 100% be abuse. Okay, it's always a race, you know, like. The hackers versus the security peeps, you know? And nobody wins. Nobody's winning. Everybody's losing. Okay, everybody, it's not that it isn't a competition, it is a competition. There are just no winners. So you really don't want to put yourself in a situation where you have that, but it's going to be terrible. Because it's connected to, like, your Ring doorbell, it's connected to, like, so many things. People are able to just walk, they'll be able to just walk around. Now, there will be some security things, so it's not like you or me or you or I or anybody would be able to just kind of walk around and, like, you know, see your cameras or maybe even unlock your door or something. It's not like anybody's going to be able to do that. But some people will be able to do that as they figure it out and kind of make it work. And, they're definitely going to be trying to get a lot of people to use it. And a lot of people are going to use it because it's opt-out. So you're able to, like, you know, nobody goes into their settings and turns off settings, right? Like, I mean, you and me and your mother, because you did it, might, right? Like there is a semblance of some kind of sanity in the world, but for the most part, people just kind of, you know, leave it. You know, they're like, oh, so it just, like, helps out my name? Sure, whatever, I don't care. You know? And there's going to be so much stuff coming because of this, just ruining everything. It's a terrible move, really. It's a terrible move. And the worst part is it's probably going to work. Just because they have a lot of money, okay? Amazon, they got a lot of money. So when the inevitable lawsuits and, like, issues and stuff start popping up, they can just pay to silence it, you know? That's what they do. And that's what McDonald's did with that lady who got burned. People still to this day think that that McDonald's lady with the coffee that burned her, people still to this day think that she was overreacting. Meanwhile, literally her vagina was fused to her legs. Like, there was actual surgery involved. And they didn't even pay for it. And that's all she was asking for. Was to have her surgery paid for. To fix her vagina. Because they burned it. With coffee that was too hot for like regulatory purposes. But people still to this day think she was overreacting because McDonald's put out this huge smear campaign on her. People were talking about her in movies. There was like ads and references in TV shows and stuff. Like, it was insane. And you know, as much as you hate it, I mean, money kinda solves problems. You need a lot of it. You need an enormous amount of it, but It solves problems. And you know who's got an enormous amount of money? Amazon. So as this Sidewalk mesh network thing comes out, it's going to be a lot of problems that come up with it. And for the most part, we're not going to hear about too much of it. Or it's not going to really blow up because they will just pay to make it not blow up. But I guarantee you there will be problems. It's such a stupid idea. I wouldn't be surprised if it ends up being like denied by, like, just not legal to do that. Honestly, I think that making things opt out like that should be illegal. I think making anything opt out should be illegal. You know? Like, everything should be opt in. Okay? And some things are like, you don't get to opt in, you don't get to opt out, you have to do it. Like, you have to pay taxes. You don't get to opt into paying taxes. You don't get to opt out of paying tax. You pay your taxes, okay? That's how it works. But, like, especially with technology and like, consumer electronics especially, stuff like that should just not be allowed to be opt out. I think that opt out is just such a stupid thing. And besides, opt out? What do you mean opt out? It's called opt in by default. What's the word I'm looking for? It's just a feature that can be disabled if you want. It's not really opt out. It's just, it's like your light bulbs. You know, you can take them out of the sockets if you want. It's not really opting out of light. it's really just disingenuous to call it opting out, in my opinion, in with stuff like this, because it isn't that you're opting out, it's that you're being forced to opt in, and then you have to choose that you want to not be, like, just... It makes me mad. It makes me so mad, dude. It makes me so mad. It's gonna mess stuff up a lot, though. There's gonna be so many problems that come up because of it. I'm fully expecting it. I'm fully expecting it. Patch yourself up. Watch Jay's 2 cents. And he's doing a 30-90 giveaway right now. So I of course signed up for that. I don't get too much into giveaways, you know. The chances of winning are like astronomically small, and then I also just whatever, you know. Like a 30-90 would be great, but bottom line is who cares? That's not a life-changing thing. That's a game-changing thing. It's not really a life-changing thing. I mean, you can go and sell it for, I don't know, $2,000 or something, but like it's a nice thing. It's not a life-changing thing. So if I don't win it, I don't really care. So they got you know, their three options or whatever on the gleam.io for signing up, getting your entries, which I always thought was annoying. Because you get entries for, like, following on social media or liking posts or whatever. And, it's annoying to me. Because I don't want to have to do that. And then other people do it and then they get that advantage for having done it, you know? Which, again, I don't really care about the giveaway, but it always just kind of irked me, you know? Anyway, what I want to talk about with regards to this is that this one, I'm winning. Okay, I'm calling it now. I'm gonna win the 30-90 from Jay's 2 cents. I feel it in my bones. You know, like I feel like I'm lucky this year, and it's just been a really good lucky year for me. You know, everything has gone well for me. I'm kidding. So I'm gonna win this 30-90, dude, and then. I'm going to make a video about it. Anyway, what I actually want to talk about is, in his video announcing it, he talked about how he doesn't like doing giveaways because every time he sends it, he, like, never gets a message back or something. And I never thought about that, right? But, like, when you give something away, because I would always message them and be like, hey, I got it, thank you so much, you know? But I guess that people don't really do that, and that would just suck, you know? Can you imagine going through the effort of... getting can you imagine going through the effort of actually setting up the giveaway, like finding all of the laws and stuff regarding it, and what the heck? I thought I was like wielding some other weapons there. It was weird. Kind of freaked me out, man. Going through the effort, you know, finding all the laws and figuring out what you can do, figuring out how you're going to be able to make it work internationally. Going through the effort of actually, like, picking somebody and then boxing it up, shipping it, paying all the shipping costs, and giving away this, like, incredibly valuable thing, and then you never even know if it arrived. You don't even know if it got there. You don't know if they got it. You don't know how much they're enjoying it. You don't know if they're using it or if they sold it or whatever happens. I would just feel bad, dude. I would feel bad, and that's why I'm never doing giveaways on this channel. We'll never do a gift. No, I'll do giveaways eventually. It's good for it's good marketing, you know. I mean, he's giving away, I don't know, like a couple $1,000s probably ultimately when it comes down to the product itself, what it's worth, and then the shipping costs and the man hours involved in it. Like it's probably a couple $1,000s, you know. For shipping this 3090 to whoever and giving it away, you know? And ultimately, he's going to end up getting a lot of extra subscribers for that. He's going to end up getting a lot of views. He's going to get a lot of all this stuff back. And it's going to kind of make up for that in the long run, right? Now, it's not like you can do it every day. Right, it's not like you can give stuff away every single day, but I mean, Mr. Beast has shown clearly that there is more than enough money to be made when you're doing, like, stupid stuff like that, right? I don't know, stupid is really weird, but stupid stuff, you know? When you're giving stuff away like that, there is money to be made in the marketing aspect of it, you know? Like, you pay a lot of money for advertisements. It's kind of the same concept, right? So I'll probably end up doing giveaways at some point, but you gotta have that capital to be able to make that kind of an investment in the marketing to be able to do that in the first place, or have something that you can give away that's valuable. Like, if I were famous, I could give away a signed picture of me or something, which just feels really vain. I know that some people do that, and I've purchased signed stuff before. Dildos. I've purchased signed stuff before, but it wasn't dildos. But it just feels really vain. I've never bought a picture of somebody that's signed. Okay? So if you were thinking that it was, you know, some lady who likes to sell pictures of herself and then sign them occasionally, it wasn't that. I've bought signed stuff, but a signed picture as a person, I don't know, it just feels weird. It feels super vain, you know? Like, I get it. If you're at the point where that's valuable, then, like, people want it, you know? Like, it almost feels rude to not do it, but then at the same time, doing it feels just insanely vain to me. Because it's literally just you. It's just you and your signature. And people are like, I want that. And you're like, yeah, I'll sell that. And it's just a picture of you with your signature. And it just feels weird to me, dude. But anyway, you can give that away if you're famous enough. I don't think any of you want a picture of me, especially with my signature on it. You know? You're like, oh, hey, look, this is a picture I could write things. Oh, no, it's already got writing on it. Now it's useless. This cat's back in the game. I've got some Path of Exile signed stuff, shirts and stuff. I've never been into the signed photos of people though. I know some people are, you know, photo, like, you get a shirt with a picture of some people on it and they've all signed it, or you get just a picture that people have all signed, or you get like a doll of somebody that they've signed, and I'm like, the doll itself is okay. The picture itself is okay. The signature itself is okay. But once you start signing yourself, it just feels like you cross a line into a vanity line that I'm not necessarily fond of personally. It just feels weird, right? To, like, sign. Can you imagine if you had, like, a model? Not model as in, like, pictures and stuff, but a model as in, like, a Gundam model or something. Can you imagine if you had a model of like, I'm trying to think of a celebrity name. I actually just can't think of any. I'm thinking of Chris Evans. Is Chris Evans a celebrity? Chris Evans. Yeah, he's a celebrity. He's Captain America. Oh yeah, he's super hot. Okay, that's a good example, actually. So you get a like Captain America model that's signed by him. You know? Like, it's just like you. But then also you signed it. And I feel like that's weird. I feel like that I don't know. If I'm ever famous to the point where people are asking me for my signature and they end up like showing me my Killing Floor 2 character and they want a signature on it, I'll probably do it. I'll do it, or they show me like my Minecraft skin or something, you know, or even just like a picture of me, or my avatar, or, you know, if they show me something that's like me, you know, and they're like, can I get your signature? I'll probably do it because, like, I wouldn't want to be rude and not give you a signature if it's in a situation where I would be doing signatures anyway. If you catch me at the store or something and you're like, can I get your signature? It's a no. I'm telling you now, it's a no. Okay, so in, you know, 20 years when I'm famous and that happens, just don't bother me in the grocery store, okay? I mean, at that point, we won't be going to grocery stores anyway. It'll all be airdropped in because pandemics are just too big of a deal for us now. But yeah, if I'm at like an event or something and people want a signature, sure, I'll sign some stuff. But there's a limit, of course, because I also want to enjoy the event, but... you know. Yeah, sure. But it would feel just so weird if somebody had like a picture of my Minecraft character or my avatar or me or my KF2 skin or anything like that. You know, if people had a picture or a model or like something representing me and then asked me to sign that, it would be a very strange thing. I'll call it at that. I would do it because I don't want to be rude, but it would be a thing that I talk about in a video. I don't know. I know people do it. I don't get it. You know? It doesn't make sense to me. I don't know why you'd want it. You know, like, I don't know why you'd want a Captain America model signed by Captain America himself. I guess I can kind of understand why you'd want it. I don't know. For me, I'm not into it. I don't like it. I think that's why I don't buy the M1911s, actually. It's because I can't afford it. I mean, I kind of... Okay, whatever. You win. Not that anybody was arguing it, but... Whatever, dude. Whatever. It doesn't matter, okay? Have we done 3 KF Rig matches, or is this just 2? I actually can't remember.
I'm back, and I've got some new tricks.
Can't remember, dude. Just don't ask for my signature in a store, and if you do, just make sure it's definitely not on a picture of me. Because if you do, you're not getting a signature.
Stay right there.
That is the worst way to get a signature. I mean, if you ask me for a signature now, you know, if somebody were to see me in a store or something like that and be like, "It's you! Can I get your signature?" I'd be like, "Who the hell are you and why are you following me?" Because I'm not at the point where people should be doing that. I mean, I don't know if people should ever be following somebody, but I'm definitely not at that point. So if somebody's following me, I'm freaked out by it. It's a weird thing though, right? Like, if you're a celebrity, you probably get that all the time, right? It's gotta be inconvenient. Gotta be inconvenient AF. People probably bother people all the time too. Like, if you see, like, I don't know, Rebecca Black out and about, anybody even remember her? Friday, 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 oh. Is that Baby? I think that's Baby. I don't know. They're both bad songs. Do I sit in the back seat or do I sit in the front seat? I don't know. I don't know how the song goes, but it's something like that, right? That was such a dumb song. I'm sorry if you're watching, but it was a dumb song. It was terrible. All the actors in it looked bored too. If you haven't seen the Friday music video, go watch it. It's a gold mine of beauty. I feel bad for her because she probably got a lot of harassing, which again is like a thing that comes with being a celebrity. That kind of sucks because people just don't respect you because you're a celebrity and all of a sudden you're a public figure instead of a human. Anyway, that's going to do it for today. Thank you for watching. Remember to like the video if you like, subscribe to see more in the future, comment if you have anything to say, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.